Hello my dear friends, my name is Tamir and this is my review on this bad boy, the digital piano ES110 of Kawai, portable piano with speakers on board. As you can see, I have here my MP7se. It's the stage piano of Kawai. It's got the best samples of Kawai, the harmonic imaging XL. This is have the harmonic imaging, the sound engine of harmonic imaging, but not XL. The difference is that the length of the sample on the XL, the length of the sample is longer, so it sounds more natural, and I think that the recording, it's a little bit on a higher scale than the sounds that came from this one, but it's very subtle. Normal people would not listen, could not identify, but if you are listening to the two instruments together, and I will do this test, you will hear the difference. So why I bought this one? So for big gigging, like if you got a lot of crowd, a lot of audience, this is the tool. If you have a proper monitors on stage and a proper a soundman and sound and everything, and you just playing, so this is the more professional one. Of course, it's got zones, it's got much more sounds, it's got four zones, it's got pitch bend and mod wheel, it's got guitars and everything. It's got everything. It's got 256 sounds, top quality sounds, okay, the MP7se. And it's got, on the piano section, it's got the new SK piano samples, okay, the SK concert grand and the SK5. It's a smaller size of SK. Of course, it's got the EX and the original concert grand of Kawai and three samples of upright. So it's got much more pianos than this. This one's got two pianos, basically. The EX, it's the older Kawai flagship concert piano. The EX, I love it more than the SK anyway. And it's got the older one, it's called the original harmonic engine. Concert piano. So basically, at this instrument, we've got basically two pianos, but eight patches. What I mean, each piano got the original one. This is the EX Grand. And you've got the studio EX Grand, so it's brighter. It's the same sound, but they tweak it to be brighter. Again, this is the normal one. And this is the brighter one. And now we go to the same piano, but mellow. Okay, same piano, three different patches. One is brighter, one is mellower. The same with the second grid, more old grand piano that used to have in Kawai. We are talking in Kawai about three generations of piano sampling. This is the first generation. The second generation was the EX Grand, and the third, the newest one, it's the SK. You've got it here on my MP7SE, and you've got it on the ES520 and the ES920, but on these instruments you've got the EX Grand and the general, let's say, the first grand piano. It sounds different. I let you hear it again, so you will listen, you remember the sound of the EX. Now this is the second grand piano on this keyboard. First grand piano, the EX. You see, it's more subtle, it's more warmth. It's all around sound better piano, the EX, from the older sample, the second piano. So usually, I'm using the EX, the first sample, and not the older one, this one. But this sounds little bit remind me of Steinway, if it's logical, because it's like a orangey, like orangey sound. This is like marble. Okay, as I told you before, the second piano, it's got the same three patches, the bright one called Studio, Studio 2, Studio Grand 2, and the metal, let's hear them. This is the Studio version of the second one. Much more brighter, and the third edition is the mellow. Okay, beautiful sound it's got, nice key bed. It's not as it doesn't have the RH3 action, but this is the RHC, the first the 520 have the RHC2, and the 920 have the same sound engine as the MP7 and the same key bed as the MP7. It's called the RH3. This one's got the RHC, a real hammer compact, something like this. It's bouncy, bouncier. It's like you know. Let's turn on the flagship, the Monster. Now, if I put the same piano sound on both of them, it's the EX, you can listen to the difference between the Image Harmonic Standard and the XL. You will hear the difference. It's weird. It somehow did transpose. Okay. It's very subtle. I don't know if you can hear it on YouTube without very, very good headphones and after the all the sound processing of YouTube and everything. There is a difference that the sound here, it's little bit less smooth. It's like, you know, it's very subtle, but you can hear that the sound here is perfect. And here, it's near perfect. I will play the same here. So it wasn't the same piano, that's why it sounds so good here. But still, even the same piano, thank you. there is a definitely improvement in the sound on this keyboard, definitely. So there, you can hear it. This is very, very good sound, but this is richer. But again, it's very hard to hear it. It's not easy to, it's very subtle nuance, but you can hear the sound. I don't know how I will hear it after, but you know, with the same, the two instruments, almost the same volume, because volume has a factor, almost the same volume, I think. For me, it sounds the same level. And anyway, why did I bought this if I have already the better one? So for small giggings and for older people like me, it's difficult to carry on a 24 kilo piano with the, I have a hard plastic bag with wheels for it, a sturdy bag. It's 10 kilo more, so it's about 35 kilos to carry around. And for small gigs, it's a big deal. Especially at small gigs, usually you don't have a monitors for you and a speakers for the crowd. So I'm playing in a band with my two brothers. One of them is guitarist and the other is a cajon, it's cajon, I don't know how to call it in English. And we are playing together three instruments, two real instruments and one electric, and the electric doesn't have speakers, you know, the stage, the professional stage piano like the MP7, the RD2000, the CP88, the Nord, they don't have speakers on board. So if you are in a band with acoustic instruments near you, and the acoustic instrument, its own body, it's the monitor that you need, but in the piano you don't hear it. So either you take this one with a sort of once I did it, I took the MP7 to small gig with a Bluetooth speaker so I can hear it, and I won't always make it louder so I can hear the instrument, and will destroy the mix, you know. If as a gigging pianist or keyboardist, you don't have a proper monitor, you will try to, you know, amplify yourself so you will hear yourself from the main speakers, and usually it will rule the mix at the end. So this is why it's very important, first of all, to have a light instrument for small gigs, and it's important that you have a proper speakers for your monitoring, so you will hear the instrument like it's an acoustic instrument. And then it will be in good balance if you are playing with other people. So this is two good reasons to buy this one. The weight for small gigs and the speakers for monitors. It's, for me, it's very important. So this one is going to stay at the studio. I don't need it outside, because 99% of the time I'm just playing the piano. So sound wise you've got the split, you've got the split option, the you know, two sounds together, how they call it. You understand what I mean? You've got these options. It's only two zones, so or split sound or merge sound, or two sounds together. But you can't make two sounds together, let's say on the right hand and bass on the left hand. Three sounds together you can't hear. Here you can do four internal and four external, but on this video I want to talk mainly on the Kawai ES110. So there are very good piano sounds, as you hear, and this is my main focus, the piano sound and the piano feel. And to my taste, Kawai is the best on both. Their piano sounds are, listen, this is supposed to be an old sample. Listen how good it is. Beautiful sound, beautiful touch. But there is something, maybe it's the difference on the keyboard, maybe it's the difference on the sound and the engine, maybe it's both. But I will, usually on my Kawais, I'm making the touch curve heavy. I don't play in the standard because it changes the sound to a little bit more mellow, and this is how I like my piano. So on the ES110 you are pressing the piano button and this B flat. Now it's hard, and there is something interesting because you can voice your piano four ways: the standard, the mellow sound. I'm not talking about the preset, I'm talking the same piano. You can, you know, manipulate it with the, how they call it, virtual technician. There is a virtual technician here, two options. So you can voice your piano four different ways. The first one, as I said, is the regular. If I'm on the middle C pressing with the piano together, this is the regular. The D will give me the mellow together with piano. The E will give me the bright. Ah, no, the E is the dynamic. This is what I want to talk about. And the F, I think, it's the bright. Yes, F is the bright. E is the dynamic. D is the mellow. And C is the regular. And you've got different, if you will hear the nuance, it's making the sound different, yes? Again. Okay, so the dynamic, it's interesting because there isn't a dynamic piano. What I mean, to make a piano mellow, you are tempering with the hammers, you are making them with needle, you are making them softer and lighter. So when the hammer will hit the string, it's got cushion to ease the strike, so then the sound, it's become muffled, not too bright, okay? And to make the piano sound brighter, the technician, on a real piano I'm talking, is making the hammer more dense. And when it's more dense and it's hitting the string, the sound is clearer and brighter, okay? So the dynamic option, I've got it on both of my pianos. It's when you are pushing softly the keys, you are getting the mellow hammers. And when you are pushing the keys harder, you are going to the dense hammer, the bright sound. And on real piano, you have either that or that. You can't have both together. Either your hammers are softer and your sound will be mellower, or brighter. But on this option, the dynamic, they take both of the worlds and combine them together. So when you are playing softly, you will get the mellow sound. When you are playing hardly, you get the bright sound. And for I have only two Kawais, so I don't know what's going on with the other Kawais, but the dynamic of the sound here, it's much more noticeable than my MP7. I will give you to hear it. You see, I'm playing now very softly. It's almost sound like pad. Almost like felt piano. Why I love this sound so much, this option, this voicing, because when you are playing with people, with other musicians, with other instruments on stage, it's this option is allowing you to go from background to front and back with the song. Like if you want to go to the background, just play light, so you became like a pad. But if you are doing now a piano solo, you understand what I'm saying? So when I'm playing with my band, it's just perfect sound. And at this sound, because when I'm pushing it slow, it's very soft and very cushion, very, it's almost like a percussion. So your left hand, you don't need to use the bass sound, because the piano, when it's so much mellow, the left side sounds just like an upright bass, very similar. okay, now I'm putting my MP7 the same way, dynamic voicing, hard key action, and you will hear that I can't do what I'm doing here. The mellow is not such mellow as this. And the bright definitely doesn't get to this. Okay, let me demonstrate this. Okay, the same, you need to believe me, touch heavy, and on virtual technician, voicing is dynamic, okay? This is my favorite way of playing my pianos. Now listen here. Even at the low, it doesn't sound pad, it sounds like a piano. A mellow piano, but it sounds, you can hear the roughness of the piano. And also at the higher pressure, it doesn't sound too bright. Here, listen to this piano. Listen. There isn't things like this. Magical. You can't do it here. This is much more convincing piano than this. There isn't any piano in the world that sounds like this. The dynamic here is preserving, it's more subtle than the dynamic here that just taking the piano outside of a range of a real piano, too much outside, because there isn't any sound like this. Thank you. Beautiful piano. So this is perfect for gigging, small gigs. This is perfect for studio. The sound quality and keyboard quality here, it's the same. It's better, one upgrade up from this. But there are some magic happening on this piano that you cannot replicate on the MP7SE. I don't have the MP11 or the higher models, but this phenomenon that happening on this sound here, it's very interesting, don't you think so? It's almost like cinematic piano. And this, what's that mean? What it means? It means that this instrument is very sensitive. If you are playing with it enough, you can do things that you can't do on any other stage piano. So, why did I choose Kawai over Yamaha P125 and Roland FP30? First of all, Roland, I don't like the piano sounds on Roland. The FP30X, they have better dynamic than the FP30 that sounds like, I don't want to say the word, but you know what I mean. Sounds horrible. But they improve the engine on the FP30X and they at last put a proper output left and right like on this one, and much more sounds, much more technology than this one. But you know, at music you have to connect with your piano, with your instrument, and the level of connection and expression that this piano have, even the 30X doesn't have. Even though the 30X, it's 5 level above the 30, the FP30, the regular Roland, because at last the pianos sounds like pianos, and not, you know, there is a good dynamic. The dynamic on Roland was horrible. The quality of the Yamaha, the sound quality, it's not the same level as Kawai on the entry level pianos. On the higher level, Yamaha and Kawai are very good competitors. I just like the Kawai sound better, less bright, more mellows. But still, the EX sound of Kawai, not the SK, not the one that you've got here, and I want to talk about it. So, but before I will go to the next subject, is to compare the piano sounds of Kawai, the SK, the EX, the SK5, and the upright, and the older model that they both have. This is, you know, I'll do it at another video, I think, because this is very important subject for me. Anyway, beautiful piano, this is. Beautiful piano, beautiful piece of art. And to tell you the truth, I have it 2-3 days about, and I didn't play almost at all on my MP7SE just because of this phenomenon, this dynamic options here. It's crazy what you can do with it. Well, it's unrealistic, this sound. It's too bright on the top and too mellow on the bottom. But, and the MP7, it's much more rounder, it's much more realistic, it's much more... It's a better instrument, okay? But I don't know what to tell you. I like it. I like it. And of course the 18/8 note sample, you know, at this, let's say low, I don't think it's low range, but let's say this is the starting range of pianos for Kawai. There isn't any cheaper than this. So it stands against the FP30, FP30X, it's a little bit more higher. So the FP30X is equal at price range to the ES520. Almost they are almost the same price, and this one is little bit cheaper than the FP30, I think, and it's cost like the Casio PXS 1000, and the Casio, I like the piano sounds, but the keyboard, it's not even, the black and the white keys are not even, and the speaker quality is less than everyone. It's less than Yamaha, it's less than Kawai, and it's less than Roland. It's that cheap speakers. So even though I bought this piano with external speakers, you don't see them here, external studio speakers with stands, so instead of 14 watts, that are nice, the speakers here are very good, but still, you know, 14 watt, it's limited. So if you are putting, and you've got here the output, so if you are putting aside it two speakers, I bought them from the Presones, I don't remember the name, 3.5, it's 50 watt speakers. You sound the piano with these 55 watt speakers together, and it sounds better than anything I've heard. Even you take the 920 with its perfect 40 watt sound speakers, my four speakers, 27 and 225, sound much better. Believe me, it sounds amazing. Amazing, and just one more $100, so this cost about $700. At $800, you are getting a machine that will blow your mind with the sound and the feel. If you are a piano hobbyist, yes, and you want to get the best you can at the minimum price you can, piano, You don't need nothing than this. Listen to the other sound, listen to the strings. Listen to the strings. Slow strings. Gorgeous strings. The second string almost sounds like a mix of strings and trumpets or something like that. No, it sounds like strings, but it sounds like a digital string. The other sounds are nice, the Wurlitzer here. The Wurlitzer here is nice sound. So this is my gigging tool, and this is my studio tool, or God will, big shows tool, this one is. So Kawai have much better sound than Yamaha, and if piano is 19/8 of your playing, then this is the one. This is the one. I almost thought someone want to buy it for me, even though I didn't open it yet. So I thought about getting the FP30X, just, you know, to have more pianos sounds, not just Kawai, but I used to have the RD-800. It's got a little bit better key action than the FP30X. It's got the concert, PH4, it's called PH4, not PH4. Yes, PH4, yes. Yes, PH4. PH4, but the better quality of PH4. So it feels like a mushi. It's good. It's more reliable action than Kawai, but it feels less like a piano than Kawai keyboards. So the Kawai keyboards are more delicate than Roland keyboard. Even though the Roland have a triple sensor on this range, the FP30 have the PH4, it's triple sensor keybed. But still, I love the Kawai better. I love the Kawai keybed at all ranges better than all the other companies. The second place will be the Yamaha. And the third place, even though technology wise the first place is Roland, okay, but feel wise I think Kawai is the first place, and because it's a little bit lighter than the RH3 on the MP7, you get fatigue less. So if you are playing 1 or 2 hours, you can run it over. You don't need to make your hand rest, because this is very, very comfortable and not very light, but it's not fatiguing your fingers as this one. This one you can play 2 or 3 hours, but your hand will start. And this is not heavy keyboard. You know, like Yamaha P515 is heavy keyboard. And you will get fatigue much quicker than any of this. And they are saying that the Kawai keyboard noise are the worst, because it's the fastest. It's like a piano. A real piano have a lot of noise, because they are making acoustic pianos. They are making their keyboards very sophisticated, with much little nuance than the other companies that don't make acoustic pianos. Because acoustic piano, just the mechanism of the keyboard, it's thousands of pieces, little pieces. So you will have the right feel of a keyboard. And that's why this supposed to be like a noisier, okay? Because it's bouncing back the fastest than any other keyboard. I think it's bouncing, let's see. No, this is bouncing faster than this, but this is have more natural way of jumping up. This is just jumps up very, very fast. Although this one, but it feels cheaper, let's say, than this one. Obviously, it feels cheaper, but still, it's got this nice feeling. There is a video of someone that compared this with A88 of Roland and Casio PX5S to decide which one to keep, and he chose this over the Casio, and he chose this over the Roland, and the Roland, it's much better keyboard. And what he says, it's that even though it's light, it's a little bit lighter than a average piano, but you can play for hours and it feels great. It gives you emotion, you know. It's so much emotion. Only at Kawai pianos, playing softly is so meaningful. So you are getting very sensitive when you are playing Kawai pianos with your muscles, with your finger muscles and touch. Because it's changing the sound dramatically, the way you are playing, more than any other company that I tried anyway. Thank you. beautiful piano. It's perfect. Okay, I wanted to talk about, I will change the, never mind, the camera angle, but this is something important. Why I bought this and didn't add some money and bought the better ES520. First of all, it cost for me almost twice, 1.5 time, okay? This cost for me, let's say, about $700. And the other one, it's a thousand, it's 1100, about 1100 or 1200, okay? And this is lighter, less samples, and less technology, because the ES520 is got a Bluetooth audio and Bluetooth MIDI, and this is have only Bluetooth MIDI, and you don't have here the SK samples and the upright at the ES520 you have. But I want to talk about the two main pianos on every Kawai digital piano, the SK, the newer, and the ES that you've got here too. So let's hear them. This is the SK. This is the flagship today. Okay, you have the piano. It's very nice piano, but it's more mellow, but the sound have more frequencies. This is more wide than the EX. Let me show you the EX. This is the EX and this is the SK. The EX, the SK. Okay, the EX, let me move here. The EX is more, looks like bright, but it's not bright, it's more clean. It's like you are using at the piano one wood. So it's getting you frequencies of this wood only. And the SK, it's like from several woods. So each wood bringing its natural frequency to the mix. So you are getting much more frequencies on each note. And when you are playing only piano, it's beautiful, it's more colors to your sound, but it gets muffled because they are hitting each other, the notes, and because they are not very clear, it making the sound a little bit muddy, let's say it like this, on the SK. That's why most of the VST plugins are made from Yamaha pianos. The Yamaha piano, the CFX, is the most sampled piano in the world. Why? Because it have the natural of the EX. So he cut through the mix very precisely. It's very clear sound. It doesn't muffle around, and it doesn't conflict with other instruments so much, because it's very clear sound as the EX. So this is very good piano for playing with others or playing while singing. And the SK sample is very good piano just for pianist as a solo piano, because it doesn't leave room on the frequency spectrum to other instruments to middle around, because it's very thick sound, okay? And this is sort of the difference, let's say, between Bechstein and Bösendorfer. Bösendorfer is very clean sound, like the EX. And the Bechstein are very white sound, like the SK. See, the core of the sound is white. You see, this is more clear, more warm, less bright, let's say. It's not brightness, because it's very mellow, but it's very rich. There are more frequencies that goes up when you are pressing one sound than this. And this is make it more like pads with bells. And this is more like a, you know, distortion guitar, let's say, as a my English, sorry. So that's why, even though you're getting much more pianos on the ES520 and much better quality speakers, it's 40 watts versus 14 watts. It's more than twice, and better action, I suppose. Even the sound engine, maybe it's a little bit, you know, newer samples maybe, but this is good enough, and this is $700. This is no money for this quality. Lightweight, you can take it with one arm, and this one, to take it out, it's a horror movie. And it's the same weight like the CP88 of Yamaha, the same weight, I think, as the Nord 3, the RD 2000, the same weight. They are all of them between 20 kilos to 25 kilos, the professional gigging machines. And this is the advantage of Kawai. Kawai make the ES8 heavy and bulky like this one, with wood panel on the sides and metal and everything. And it's nice. This is plastic, you see? It's plastic, but the weight is very important.